online classes GKR Vedanta. Today we start chapter 9 with topic comparing quantities. Before class you compare many things as a ratio, percentage, fractions. Today we learn about what our topic is, comparing quantities. In before class you compare using the ratio, percentage, all these things. Now we today learn what is if the words, amounts or any number of data is given. Suppose compare what using the ratio. Suppose 24 by 28 is there. Okay, 24 by 28 is there. Then we compare both part of words. 28 part of 24 is there, 28 part of 24 is there. Then what is the limit in writing towards 24 is to 28 also. Okay, when it is compared, it is ratio. Ratio. Now we can reduce also the both number. The number is divided by which one? 4. 4 is the what? 24. 4 7 is 28. Then when we reduce and write, then compare means always write the lowest number of the given numbers. Given numbers, then here the numbers divided by 4, 4 is 24, 4 7 is 28. That means 6 by 7, then compare is 6 is to 7. Then any amount, anything that is the 6 part of 7, that means if we got then 6 times, then another is 7 times of the given data. Okay, 7 times of the given data. Now to compare two quantities, units must be same. That means when you compare the two quantities, then their units must be same. Suppose what are the units? 5 kg, 800 gram. Here see, kg and gram, both are the different units. Then when we compare the both quantities, then change into the same units. Then kg is converted into the gram, then 5 kg is converted into the mean of what? 1 kg equal to how many gram? 1000 gram. Then 5 kg is to 1000 equal to, is to, okay, 1 kg equal to 1000 gram. Okay, now that 5000 gram is to 800 gram. We can reduce it using what? 0, 0 cancel, 0, 0 cancel. Then again, divisible by 2, 25 is to 4 jar 8. Then we write here 25, here 4. Then 25 is to 4, we can write it to 25 by 4 also. Okay? That means 25 gram is to 4 gram. Then when we compare any parts, quantities, then their units will be always same. Meter, centimeter. We can able to what? Compare the both things, because meter and centimeter is other different quantities. One, because 1 meter is 100 centimeter. That's why always we convert into the same one units and compare the quantities. Now we know about the ratio. What is ratio? Always ratio. We compare the ratio using the this quantity. Okay. Now we take an example. Many examples for the ratio. Okay, now we discuss about the ratio and comparing. How can you compare ratio? Then what is sign of ratio? Sign of ratio. Okay. Now we take different examples like compare given. Then we can change into the easily large units to small units. Always try to change the units, largest units to smallest units, because when you convert the large, smallest units to large units, it's so little covers hard. So we can always try to but convert large units to small units. Okay. Solution for one. Here 2 liter to 500. 500 ml is there. Now we know what 1 liter equal to what? 1000 ml. 1 liter equal to 1000 ml. here, 2 liter equal to 2000 ml, that means 2000 to 500 ml. That means what? 2000 by 500. Here, 0 insert, 0 insert, 5 for the 20, 5 for the 5. That means what? 4 by 1 equal to 4 is to 1. We can represent the data that given what? 2 liter to 500 ml, that means we convert first the unit, same unit, because their units are different. When we compare the two data, that given data are, then always what change into same units. Then that's why I change here what? Same units, liter into ml. Liter into ml, then 1 liter into that, 1000 ml, 1000 ml into 2000 ml, 500. Then 2000 by 500 equal to 4 by 1, that is 4 is to 1. And we change that. The next one is what? 6 rupees 6 to 80 paise. How can you compare the both things? Okay. Here, their unit is same or different. See here rupees and paise. Both have different units. Then first we convert into the both the quantities into same units. Now we solve the second question. What is the second question is what? Here, second question is. Rupees 6 to 80 paise. Here see paise and rupees. Both have different units. Now we change into units what? 1 rupees 100 paise. 1 rupees 100 paise. Then 6 rupees.
That means here 45 by 4 is
to 4. Okay, then how can you compare the two numbers between ratio? You compare the relative ratio first, comforts change into the same units, then rides and the hertz. We can search what 25:4. Now we'll take another example for ratio. How can you divide the ratio? Okay. Next example, suppose you take what kilometers. So 1 kilometer to 500 meters. You know, here kilometer and meters, both have same units or different units. Kilometer and meters have same units or different units. Different units is there. Now then we know that what 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer equal to what? 1,000 meter. We know that 1 kilometer equal to 1,000 meter. We know that. Now then 1,000 meter is converted. Now the unit is same. 500, 1,000. Right here 1,000 by 500. 0, 0 cancel. 0, 0 cancel. 5 into 10. 2 by 1 = 2:1. Okay, clear? How can we convert using the same units and doing the comparison between two quantities or two data? Okay, the two data is given: kilometer and meter. Kilometer and meter then change into the what? Meter. And we can do it. Okay. Here question is, here out of 750 students in a school, that means a school has how many total students? 720. And 280 are boys and remaining are girls. And what are the questions there? Are three questions given: boys to the that of girls. That means we find the ratio boys to girl, boys to total student and total student to girls. Then there we don't know how many girls is there. Then first we find out the number of girls, how many number of girls. Then here solution, we solve the answer. First here total number of student. Students here how many? 720. Then total number of boys. The boys is given in a school, 280 are boys. That means the boys. Then total number of boys. Total number of boys equal to what? 280. Then we can watch first we find the total number of girls. Then the number of girls. How can you find the number of girls? See, to here total student how much? 720 and boy how much? 280. Then we can find the girls from total students subtracted 280. Then total girls equal to what? We how can find 720 minus 280. 0, 12 minus 8, go to 1, 12 minus 8 equal to 4, 6 minus 2 equal to 4. 440. Then total number of girls, how many total number of girls is there? 440. Now we know total students, boys, girls according to questions. Okay, 440 is there. I am usually I write here 400. Okay, 440. Okay, 700 280. 440 is there. Now according to question we solve the first question is what? Boy to the girls. Boy to the girl. Girl means what? The ratio. What is the question? Find the ratio of the given question for the first one. Solution is here. Boys to girl. Boys is to girl. Then boys are what? 280 is to 440. Now we can reduce it. 280 boys is to girl. Then 280 is to 440. That means 280 by 440 is there. Now 0, 0 cancel. The number is divided by 2. 2 into 2, 2 into 8. 2 into 4, 2 into 4. Again divided by 2. Then 2 7 into 14. 2 into 2, 2 into 2. Then 7 by 7. 7 by 7 equal to what? 7 is to 2. 11 is there. Okay. Then what is the ratio of boys is to girls? Boys is to girls ratio is 7 by 11. How can we find? We take the boys and girls. Then boys when we reduce in lowest form, then we got what? 7:11. If you don't, if you are lying, then you use the SCF process. How can you find the SCF and write the lowest one of the given number C? Here we do have, suppose you write here, what which one are there? 280 and 440. We know that here, plan also SCF, then 2 1 4, 2 4 8, 2 into 0, 0, okay? 2 2 4, 2 2 4, 0, 0. Now the number is divided by 2, 2 7 4, 3, 2 1 2, 2 1 2, 0, okay? Now again divided by what? 2 35 is there, 2 3 6, 1 10, 2 5 10, 2 5 10, 2 5 10, 1 2 5 10, 55. Again the number is divided by which one? The unit digit is 5. Then the if the both numbers the unit digit is 5, then the number is divided by which number? 5. Then we divide by 5. 5 7 is 35. 5 1 is 5. 5 1 is 5. Now see the both numbers divided by and not any number. How can we find the SCF? SCF means the numbers given both are divided by a single number. But here 7 is a prime number, 11 is a prime number. The prime number is not divided by any number. 1 into itself. Then what is the lowest form of the numbers? Then you can write it 7 by 11. What is the lowest form of the number? 7 by 11 or 7:11. You can easily find the answer using SCF or using the reducing. Okay. If you don't know the reduce, if you don't know the table, then use the this process and easily you can find the answer. Okay. How can you got the number one answer here? Now we find the second solution. What is second solution? Boys to total student. Boys to total student. How many boys is there? How many boys? Right here. Boys to total student. Boys to total student. Boys is 280. Total student is what? 720. Let me write here. 280 is 720. Now we write what? 280 by 720. Okay. 0, 0 cancel. 0 and 0 cancel. Now division by 2, 14, 36, 7, 18. And what is here? 7 by 18 by 2, 7 is to 18. This is the answer. The total, the boys to the total student is 17:18 is there. You can find also 280 by 720 using SCF process. Okay, which process? SCF. Here we what we find? SCF. SCF, then the last number are, first one is right is a numerator, second one is right is a denominator, okay? You can easily solve it. Now we solve third bit, okay? Third bit. What is question of third bit? I erase bits 1 and bit 2, okay? Third bit question is what? Total student to girl. Total student to girl. Third bit. Total student to girl. Okay. Total student 720. Right here 720. Total student 720 and girls 440. Right here 440. 0 0 cancel. 2 3 6. 1 2 6 12. 2 2 4. 2 2 4. Again divided by 2. 1 2. 2 8 16. 2 1 2. 18:11. Then total number of girls is what? 2 4 40. And total student is 720. Then what is the ratio of total student by girl is 18:11. Also you can finding SCF. Okay? How can you find the SCF ratio using the questions? Clear? All of you understood? Now we'll take how can we dividing given the ratio. How can we divide the ratio? Okay? Now we learn how can dividing a ratio the given numbers, okay? And how can we divide dividing the given ratio number? If one number is given and divided into 5:6 ratio, then how can we do it now for the answer, okay? Let's सपोज क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज टॉपिक डिवाइडिंग व्हाट डिवाइडिंग ए गिवन नंबर इन द गिवन नंबर इन द व्हाट गिवन रेशियो then dividing means what we can how can you divide a numbers that according to that ratio then first we take an example suppose question is here 108 okay how can you divide into 108 into to two ratio what are the two ratio 4 is to 5 then if you write a question then what is the question divide 108 is 4 is to 5 or is what into two parts 108 into two part is what 4 is to 5 4 is to 5 what are the two parts what is the ratio of two parts that we have divide what 108 into two parts sorry here 4 is to 5 is there okay 4 is to 5, not 4 is to 8. Okay, then what is the word? Then divide that means for sum equal to two parts is there. We got it. Then solution. How will you solve it? Let the two parts are two parts are 4x and 5x. 4x and 5x. Then it should be divided into two parts. So there 4x plus 5x. Equal to 108. Let me solve. One part, two part. Then when you divide, divide into two parts, we can adding and subtraction divide here. 9x equal to 108. X equal to 108 by 9. Then when we 9 divided by 9, then what is the answer? 12. 9 into 9. From 9 to 18. 1 to 12. Okay. We got the value of x. The next equal to what? 12. Then first part we take it for what? 4x. And what is the value of x is here? 12. Then we write here 4x equal to 4 into 12. 38. Then 5x. 5x equal to what? 5 into 12 equal to 60. Okay? Then the two parts are what? 48 and 60. We divide 108. Into two parts. The two parts are what? 48 and 60. 48 and 60 are the two parts. When we divide into ratio of 4 is to 5, then that is what? 100. It is correct or not 100? It is not. How can we know? 48 plus 60 equal to 108. Okay. 48 and 60 equal to 108. Equal to 108. Now we change into ratio. That ratio comes. 4 is to 5 or not. The given the two parts are gone, comes what? 4 is to 5 or not, how can we check? We check here, we write here, what? 48 by 60. 48 by 60, that means 48 by 60 if comes 4 is to 5, then our dividing is correct. If 48 by 60 is not come 4 is to 5, then our dividing are not correct. Then we can verify it, it is equal to our HS. Okay, 12 4 jar, what? 48, 12 5 jar, 60. 4 by 5 equal to 4 is to 5, verify. Okay, you can check your answer yourself. It's no need to any other things. Okay, you do the answer and you can verify it yourself. We'll take another example for the dividing a ratio. Okay, now see another examples. Let's example is what divide 200 into two part is 6 is to 4. Then we take what? Let two parts are. Two parts are what? 6x and 4x, we know that 6x plus 4x equal to 200, 10x equal to 200, x equal to 200 by 10 equal to 20. We got the value of x is what? 20. Then 6x equal to what? 6 into 20 is there. Then 6 to the power is 120. Another part is what? 4x. 4x equal to what? 4 into 20. Then 4 into 4 into 8. It is there. Now the sum of the two parts, 80 and 120, is what? 200. That means our part is what? The sum of the two parts are equal. Okay? Here about it, sum in hand, also we can change into what? Ratio. Then, what? Change into ratio, that means what? 120 by 80 is there. Now 0, 0, 2, 6, 7, 2, 4. That is that comes 6 by 4. Equal to 6 is to 4. That means what? We got the equally and correct into two parts. That two parts are 120 and 80. When we divide into two parts, 120 and 80, then it should be what? 200. Clear about it? How can you divide the ratio as given numbers? Okay. Now we discuss about the comparing ratio. How can you compare two ratio? Okay. Now we discuss comparing two ratio. How can you compare two ratio? Which ratio is smaller and which ratio is greater? Now see. Comparing ratio. Between two ratio, but first we have to take examples. 5 is to 6 and what? 3 is to 8. Now we compare the both ratio, which ratio is greater and which ratio is smaller. Then how can you go? How can we compare? We know 5 is to 6 have 5 by 6 and 3 is to 8 have 3 by 8. Okay, 3 by 8 is there. Now we find the LCM of denominators. Now, what? Find LCM of both have both denominators. Okay, LCM of 6, 8. Then 6 and 8, 2, 3 is 2, 4 is 2 into 2 into 4. 2 3 are 6. 6 4 are 24. LCM are what? 24. We got the LCM of 24. Now we write here 5 by 6. 5 by 6, the denominator which are there? 24. 24 is there. Now we divide which one? Step 2. It wants step 1. Then step 2 is what? 24 divided by first fraction denominator equal to 4. 6 4 is 4, then the 4 is multiplied by which one? Both denominators, that means 4 5 is 20, 6 4 is 24. Okay, now third number, fourth number is what? Third fourth step is what? Second number is what? 8. Then 24 divided by 8 equal to 3. Then the 3 is multiplied with both another fractions denominator and numerator. 3 by 8 into 3, 3 by 8 into 3. Okay, now we write here 9 by 24. Okay, see here denominator are what same? If two fractions have denominator are same, then which is greater than other? Then the denominator having which denominator is greater than other, greater than others. Here 20 by 4 is greater than 9 by 24. Okay, then we can compare the two ratio. Then which is greater? We write here which 20 by 24 is greater than 9 by 24. So 5 by 6 equal to 5 is to 6 is greater than 9 by what? 24. 9 by 24 is equal to what? 3 is to 8. Then we can easily compare to two ratio which is greater and which is smaller. See here which is greater here? 5 is to 6 is greater than 3 is to 8. will take another example for the comparing two ratio. Okay, how can we compare the two ratio? We'll take another example. Same here, this now. Today we know about the ratio and how can we compare the two quantities, and also comparing the ratio and lowest form and how can we divide according to the ratio. Next class we will discuss about the what. Next which one is proportion. Okay, bye.